quiet.
Thank you.
There, I have written my book. Now I'm going to publish it on my magic printing press. So, what else can you do? Well, I have this keep here, and I've furnished it as a library. I made all these bookcases and furniture and gathered books and items, and I furnished it. So it's cool that there's player housing, there are player towns and player houses, and you can write books. I decorated this whole bookcase. So I just wrote that book, and the name of the book is A Serious Question. Now you can see it's a book in the game that other players can read if I publish it on my magic printing press, which I'm gonna do right now. All right, so onto the magic printing press, I put the book, and then to make copies of it, I have to put a bunch of blank books. So let's make like 6 copies. Then I click craft. Bam! Look at that. I just published 1, 2, 6 copies of the book that I just wrote in the game. So now I can go share it with other players. Like, I think I'll put a copy of it right here on my. On my table, A Serious Question by Leila Kin. My name in the game is Leila Kin. Super fun and super immersive because there's so much to do. I was thinking I would put. Oh, that's the interesting question. So I wrote a book called An Interesting Question, and now I've also written one called A Serious Question. But the interesting question one. Was poorly edited, so I'm not gonna leave it there. Looks like I missed. Yeah, it's totally. You're right on. Right on. It is. Because it's created by Lord British, Richard Garriott. And Richard Garriott. He created Ultima Online and all the Ultima games and Tabula Rasa and a lot of other games that I've loved. And I really like that he's doing this. He's got a really great team, a bunch of people who. Tracy Hickman. Awesome writer. He has helped write part of this game, and I'm just putting this book that I wrote around. And he's just I'm gonna portal away. He's helped with the game. Starlong from Ultima Online is on here, and Chris Spears, who's worked on a lot of really cool games, is in here. That's very cool. A book fair? I feel like I need to go upstairs and publish more copies of this book. Let's go back to the printing press. But yeah, there's really cool combat, which is super fun. Let's publish more copies of this. I've got some more blank books here. Why not? Ta-da! That is badass. Magic printing press. I'm so happy with that. It's just cool. That's weird. I had some notes here, but I don't know where they are. I feel like something changed. Huh. Heaps of changes coming. Yeah. This is a pre-alpha. They're on the Unity engine, and the game continues to change and evolve. There will be a lot of changes, like Cooper Class says. Cooper Class. So I put these braziers here and some benches to sit on. This is a good. I like sitting outside and reading, so maybe I need to put a copy. I need actually this as soon as I find the lost text, which is just a euphemism for I got lazy and was tired of writing. As you noticed at the end, how did I get into it? You can pledge and support the development of the game. It's available on Steam and on their website. I'll link it to you. Let's see, so I have given away 5 Steam keys, a $50 in-store game credit. I've given away 2 founder level pledges, which I'll show you. Here's the pledge page. So you can see all the different levels of pledge. So I gave a, you get the adventure level pledge through Steam. You can see it there. Adventure, pioneer, first responder, second responder. Then I gave away 2 founder pledges this past week. And I've also given away a couple patron pledges. I gave away 1 citizen pledge, which is the $550 level. So, and I will be giving away more because I just think that this game is fantastic, and I'm a diehard MMOer, and I like lots of other types of video games as well. But right now I'm just really, really, really loving Shroud of the Avatar, so I like to support it and get other people to play it. I have a little pet kitty cat that came with my pledge. I wish I could name my pet though. It won't let you name your pet. It just says black cat. That's cool about EverQuest, big guy, little guy. I played EverQuest 2 when it came out. EverQuest, Asheron's Call, Ultima Online. This reminds me a lot of Star Wars Galaxies 2, and they're switching to a use-based skill system similar to SWJ. Also, I like that the quest lines for each individual are They kind of remind me of SWG2, Star Wars Galaxies. Nice. I was a wizard. Cooper Claws. Yeah, I made a YouTube highlight of you giving me the village deed lot and the village, the keep that I have. Let me go show you. And I decorated it, and I'm beside myself. And it was really generous. You gave me a rent-free Founder Village lot deed. And then that was super generous and super nice. Oh, really? No, I don't think so. Okay, someone else gave that to me. Let's see. I first started playing Release 6 or 7, and I've streamed it all. I streamed, that's all in my highlights on Twitch. Oh, hi Ken, how are you? Good morning. Sorry, I wasn't really planning on streaming for very long because we're out of coffee. I just woke up, we're out of coffee, and I need to go out. So I was just gonna kind of like fart around in the game for a minute, but now I'm talking to you guys. But good morning, children. Yeah, Sam gave me the house that I was just at in Aldwater, but somebody from my guild, the Weeping Seven, gave me this. This is the village deed, village lot and house in Owl's Head on the very far west end. And R15 I didn't play. No, I stopped playing in R13 and I just started playing R21. I mean R20. Jimmy Dums for coffee. Okay, so this is my house that I decorated. You can see this sign here, Village Lot. And I have a Knight Benefactor house, which I'm not pledged for. So this is not what I could afford with my current pledge. This is just because somebody in the game. That's funny, Cooper Claws, because I didn't play. I haven't played since Release 13. I took a huge break. And I played Grand Theft Auto and Ark, and I got into other games, and I did a lot of real-world traveling. And just when Release 20 came out, I joined the day Release 20 hit, and joined the Weeping Seven Guild, and they gave me this. So I've decorated this house, and I'm just curious if I could put my book on this bench. Wait, why does that happen? Why does that happen? It's not open world PvP, but there are PvP zones. For instance, right now, all the cities are PvP zones, but that won't always be that way. Player owned towns, like my town. Why does that say Shepherd in the Sea on the bench, but in my inventory, it's my book? I feel irritated by that. What? Now it says a serious... Oh, it's so confusing. It said Shepherd in the Sea. Now it says a serious question. So this is a book that I read in the game that you can read. A Serious Question by Leila Kin. That's weird. Okay. I think R 2021 will be really cool because there are going to be dragons. Yay, dragons! There are going to be dragons. I wrote this. This is the note at the entrance to my house. There are going to be dragons. There are going to be use-based skill levels. Skill. I love that. I'm trying to think of what else stood out for me. It's cool because the devs share their development process with you, and there are no kinds of player vehicles or mounts right now in the game. Yeah, let's get interesting question off of here because it's got an editorial bug, and we'll put a serious question down here. Where else can we put? Here we go. A serious question. What book is it? I'm looking for a particular book. What book am I looking for? A heart of the most beautiful heart, I think. Most beautiful heart I'm looking for. I wonder, right, here's I want to put it up in my library. I'll put it in my library. Self-promotion. I don't think I'm good at self-promotion. I am. If I was good at self-promotion, I would have a Twitch subscription button, which they won't give me because they say, listen to this. Twitch's policy for giving you a subscription button is that you have an average of 500 viewers per 3-hour stream. And I would like you to go look at a bunch of Twitch streamers who have a subscription button and they have nowhere near an average of 500 viewers per 3-hour stream. So that's frustrating to me. I've applied 3 times and I talk about the games that I play. I do everything from Battlefield 4 to Rust to King's Quest, and World of Warcraft rating, and I do indie games. I do, you know, A+ games. I do everything. I do Magic the Gathering and MOBAs and RPGs, and it's just crazy. No, like Serious Gaming, they stream all day, every day. And they never have an average of 500 viewers. I mean, maybe on the weekend or something, but average of 500. I usually have maybe 3 to 10 people watching. So who knows? Who knows, man? Who knows? I just do it for fun. I've played video games as long as video games have existed, and I love them. I love sharing the games that I'm playing. Later, Cooper Claus. Nice seeing you again. Thank you. Oh, I usually do have my camera on. I do usually have my camera on, and I don't think I sexualize it. I'm just me. Definitely just me. Ninety percent of my streams I have a camera on. Yeah, that's unusual. Most Twitch streamers aren't like that, so that's just the top Twitch streamers. I usually do have my camera on. I have a lot of past broadcasts and highlights you can see. I also have my YouTube channel. It's linked on this page. My YouTube channel has a lot of highlights of my gameplay. Oh, that happens here, believe me. I mean, I am a female, so people make their sexist comments as they will. I mean, you'd think that some of the guys who come in here have never seen a woman before. They're like, oh my God, your boobs are out. Well, I'm a female. I have boobs. Am I supposed to wear a smock? We're not in Afghanistan. Jesus. Anyway, yeah, that makes me mad when people act that way. Tatsumasa! Hi, Tat, Tatty Tat. See, that's me right there. So you might take back what you just said. You'll be like, oh. That's a picture of me last week. Streaming. I was streaming last week. Okay, so I really need coffee and breakfast, and I wasn't really planning on streaming for very long. So I will be back later. I have to get breakfast and coffee. Our house is empty of coffee. I cried when I went through the cupboards and there were no. It's just women have breasts, and we live in the United States of America. There's nothing wrong with wearing a tank top or a low-cut shirt. It's uptight as fuck to think that women shouldn't be able to show cleavage or so. I just, I don't have any problem with cleavage or boobs, and I also don't think it's over-sexualizing, but. I have to go though. I'm gonna be back later. Thank you for stopping by. Don't forget to follow me. And thanks, Tat. I'm gonna go out and get coffee and breakfast. I just heard my husband wake up. So, well, he's been up for a while. I heard the shower, so hopefully he's ready. I'm ready to go get coffee. Then I'll come back on my camera and talk to you guys and play this game more. There, is that better? Because there's no cleavage. So this is somehow like a better picture. I'll talk to you guys later.